So today we will be doing the problems and we will see how to use the Ohm's law, how to use voltage divider rule, current divider rule, how to solve the resistances in series and resistances in parallel. So let us go to the first problem. So I hope you have your notebook and your calculators with you. A simple calculator is enough for now. So let us take down the first problem. Find the equivalent resistance between points A and B. Shown in the figure. So the circuit is given. So let me draw the circuit first. So 3 ohm. 4 ohm and 4 ohm, 2 ohm and then I have 5 ohm and 6 ohm and then 7 ohm. So I need to find out the equivalent resistance between this. So how can you find out this? So you have to solve for the series resistances, parallel resistances and find out the equivalent resistance. Now if you see here in this question, the first thing that you can see is you can first solve this parallel resistances. So you have three parallel resistances, 3 ohm, 4 ohm and 4 ohm in parallel. So if I let me take the first parallel resistances as RP1. Okay, so first I have to find out what is this RP1. So first, now you know you have three resistances, you have to find out the equivalent resistance. So according to the formula, 1 by RP1 is equal to 1 by 3 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4. RP1 is 1.28, correct. So 1 by RP1 is around 0.833. So RP1 you will get 1.2 ohms. So your circuit will end up with, if I have to draw, now your circuit looks like this. So now you can solve this series resistance and this series resistance. So what will it be? So 2 plus 1.2, that will be your first branch. 5 plus 6 will be your second branch. Right, so you have, say let me take series, so RS1, let me take 2 plus 1.2 will give you the first branch, okay, so that will be 3.2 ohms and then the next branch, so next branch is 5 plus 6, so that will give you the second branch, so you have 11 ohms. So your circuit will again end up with, now again, 3.2, 11 and 7, all three are in parallel. So again, you need to find out the parallel resistance. So 1 by RP2 is equal to 1 by 3.2 plus 1 by 11 plus 1 by 7. So what will be RP2? You get 1.8308 some ohms. So finally, your circuit will look like this, 1 ohm. Your this resistance is equivalent resistance is nothing but 1.83 ohms. So B and A. So this is again in series. So your RAB equivalent resistance will be 1 plus 1.83. So you will end up with 2.83 ohms. Let us go to the next one. So I have a circuit A and B. So you have to find out the equivalent resistance across the supply terminals. So first, how can we solve this? So if you see here in your problem, you can see here 4 ohm, 16 ohm and 4 ohm are in series, right? So how can you say it is in series? You can see one end of this, the first resistor, is connected to the another end of the second resistor, whereas the second end of the second resistor is connected to the third end of the third resistor, right? If it is in parallel, what happens? You will have resistors like this. That means two ends of the one resistor are connected to the two ends of the another resistor. You can see you have a common point connected, correct? So this is what this, if you find a circuit like this, you can say it is in parallel because you have a common point, two common points. Whereas if you see here, you have only one common point for this one resistor. For this resistor, if you compare, you have only one common point. So when you have one common point, it is said to be in series. If you have two common points, if I take this and this resistor, you can see they have two common points. If I take this and this resistor, again two common points. This and this resistor, you can see two common points. That means it is in parallel. So based on this, you can analyze if it is in series or in parallel. Now first, since 4 ohm, 16 ohm and 4 ohm, all these three resistances are in series. So your first equivalent resistance, let me take this as RS1. So 4 plus 16 plus 4. So this one will give you 24 ohms. So now your circuit will look like, this is 24 ohm. So this three resistances, I have already found out the equivalent resistance for it. So that is nothing but 24 ohm. Now again, if you see, if you compare this and this resistor, you can see they have two common points, correct? So since they have two common points, that means it is said to be in parallel. So I can solve this next. So RP1 is equal to, so you know when you have two resistances in parallel, you can use this formula. RP is equal to R1 into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. 4 into 24 divided by 24 plus 24. So that will give you 12 ohms. So next your circuit will end up with 8 ohms. 8 ohms. 24 ohm, 6 ohm, 6 ohm, and this is 12 ohm. Now again, if you see 6, 12 and 6, all these are in series. So 24 ohm. So next, your circuit will look like, so this is what it looks like. So again, if you see, this is in parallel. So again, use R1 into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. So you will get 12 ohms. So again, your circuit will end up with 8 ohms, 12 ohm and 8 ohm. So your, so that one will be 28 ohms. So your equivalent resistance, R equivalent is equal to 28 ohms. So next, the next question, in the voltage divider given below, given that V is equal to 50 volts, and the voltage across R2 is 100 ohms is 20 volt. Calculate the value of R1. So the circuit is given. So 50 volts supply. You have two resistors. So R1 and R2. So R2 is 100 ohms. So voltage across R2, that is V2, is equal to 20 volts. You have to find out what is the value of R1. So how can you find out this? Now, if you remember your voltage divider equation, so your voltage divider equations you had, V1 is equal to V into R1 divided by R1 plus R2. Another equation, that is for V2. V2 you had as V2 equal to V into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Now I need to find out what is R1. The rest of the thing, rest of the quantities, that is V2, you know what is V, you know what is R2. So therefore you can substitute that. So V2 is equal to 20 equal to V is 50 into 100 divided by R1 is the quantity that you need to find out, and R2, 100. So, what will be R1 from this? To 150 ohms. So, next, let us go to the fourth question. A resistance of 10 ohm is connected in series with two resistances each of 15 ohm arranged in parallel . What resistance must be shunted across this parallel combination so that the total current taken shall be 1.5 amps with 20 volt applied. So they have given you the question, they have not given you the circuit. So it is your duty to read the problem and then draw the circuit. So if you see, they have given you resistance of 10 ohm is connected in series with two resistances each of 15 ohm. So that means 10 ohm is in series with the parallel resistances. So two parallel resistances, and both the parallel resistances are of 15 ohm. So with two resistances each of 15 ohm arranged in parallel, what resistances must be shunted across this parallel combination? So when they are saying shunted, that means they are saying There is another resistance which is in parallel with this combination. So let me take this as say R. So you have to find out what is this R. So what resistance must be shunted across this parallel combination so that the total current taken shall be 1.5 amps with 20 volt applied. That means total voltage applied is 20 volts. Total current, current I, is equal to 1.5 amps. So you need to find out what is R. So how can we find out what is R? Now, if you see this, this is a series resistance, right? For series parallel circuit. So you can see 10 ohm is in series with this combination. So you know voltage across 10 ohm will be different and voltage across this combination will be different, correct? So what I'll do is, first let me find out what is V1. Now you know Ohm's law, V is equal to I into R. Now that is V1 is equal to I into 10 ohm resistance. Okay, so I want to find out what is V1. Now you know current across this current going through this resistance is nothing but 1.5. Resistance is nothing but 10, so you can find out what is V1. So from this, what will be V1? V1 will be equal to around 15 volts. Now you have already found out V1. That means you can find out easily what is V2, right? Because V is equal to V1 plus V2. Now V, you already know V is nothing but 20 volts. V1 you have found out above, so 15 plus V2. So from this you can say V2 is equal to 5 volts. Next, I have already got what is V2. Now I want to find out what is the current across this. So now if you see, the current going through this is the main current. Now at this point what happens is the current divides. So I can say, I can take this current across 15 ohm as I1, current across this 15 ohm as I2, and current across this R as I3. So in this case, now again using your Ohm's law, so say V2 is equal to I1 into 15. So what is V2? V2 you already know, you can easily find out what is I1. So I1 will be equal to 5 divided by 15. Next, similarly you can find out what is I2. Now I2 is equal to again V2 divided by 15. That is, this is nothing but the resistance, right? Using this V is equal to I into R formula. So V2 is again 5 divided by 15. You will find out what is I2. So what is I1? 5 divided by 15. So 5 divided by 15 is around 0.33. Now you have already found out what is I1 and I2. Now according to the circuit, you can say the main current I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. Now you already know what is the main current, you know what is I1, you know what is I2. I3 is the only quantity that you don't know. So let me use that relationship. So I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. So I main current I is 1.5 amps. I1 is 0.33, I2 is 0.33. So 0.33 plus 0.33 plus I3. So what was I3 from this? 0.84 amps. So I have found out what is I3 now. So I3 is equal to 0.84 amps. Now if you see this, you know what is the current which is going through this branch. You also know what is the voltage in this across this branch. So you can easily find out what is the unknown resistance R. So V is V2 is equal to I3 into R. So V2 is equal to 5 volts. I3 is 0.84 into R. So R is equal to 5 divided by 0.84. So what will be R? 5 divided by 0.84. So 5.9523 ohms. So this is how you are using your Ohm's law when you are getting like this circuits. So whenever you have two resistances in parallel or two resistances in series, you can use your voltage divider, current divider rules. But when you have more than that resistances, in that case you will have to go through like this. So next, let us go to the next question. So find the value of resistance R as shown in the below figure so that current drawn from the source is 250 milliamps. All the resistor values are in ohm. So they have given the circuit. So this is 30 ohms, this is 40, and this is 40. So here you have a resistance in parallel. So this is unknown resistance R. So across this, the voltage is applied. So this is 5 volts. So you have to find out what is R. So first, now if you see here, you have to find out what is R here. Now, how can you solve this problem? Now, the first thing that you can do is, first you can solve this 40 and R. Now, you can see 40 and R in an R in parallel, right? 40 is parallel with resistance R. So, let me first find out the what is the equivalent resistance of that. So, equivalent resistance So let me take RP1 is equal to what will it be? 40 into R divided by 40 plus R. So I'm using this formula, R1 into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. This is the formula when to be used when two of the resistances are in parallel. So once I have found out this equivalent resistance for these two parallel resistances, my circuit will look like this. So this is 30 and this is the now this two resistances we have already solved, so this is nothing but 40 into R divided by 40 plus R. This is 40. Then you have the supply voltage plus minus 5 volt. So now let me simplify the circuit. So how does it look? So if you see here, 40 into R divided by 40 plus R is in series with 40, right? You can see there is only one common point, so I can also write it like the circuit like this. This is 40 into R divided by 40 plus R. 40. Next, you can see 30 is in parallel with these two series resistances, right? So I can write like this, 30. Next, the supply voltage, if you see, it is given across this 30 ohm. So you can write it like this. So your circuit will look like this. So now if you see here, again 40 into R, 40 plus R and 40 ohms, both are in series. So first let me solve that. So your equivalent series resistance will look like, will be like this. So equivalent series resistance. So 40 into R divided by 40 plus R and 40 R in series. So addition of these two resistances. So let me find out what is that. So you can see 40 plus R is common. So if I take it like this, 40 R plus 40 into 40 plus R, right? So what will it be? So your final answer will be 40 R plus 40 R. So it will be 80 R plus 40 into 40. That is 1600 divided by 40 plus R. So this is your equivalent resistance. That means your circuit will now look like this. This is 80 R plus 1600. Divided by 40 plus R, and then you have 30 ohms, and then the supply voltage across this so your circuit will look like this. Now again, if you see, these two resistances are in parallel. So let me find out the equivalent parallel resistance. So equivalent parallel resistance will be, so let me substitute in this formula, R1 into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. So what is R1 here? 80 into R plus 1600 divided by 40 plus R into R2 is 30 divided by 80 R plus 1600 divided by 40 plus R plus R2, that is R 30. What will it be? Let me write this. Let me multiply 30 with this. So if you are multiplying 30, what will it be? So 2400 into R, 30 into 80 plus divided by 40 plus R. Similarly, the denominator, now you can see if I take 40 plus R as common, that means it will be 80 R plus 1600 plus 30 into 40 plus R. So what will it be? 30 into 40 is 1200 plus 30 R. Now you can see this and this can be cancelled. So you will be left with 2400 R plus 48,000 divided by 80 R plus 1600 plus 1200 plus 30 R. Correct? So so what is this? 48,000 divided by 80 plus 30. So this is nothing but 110 R plus 1600 plus 1200. So that will give you around 28,000. Right? So now, let me take this as the answer. Now, this is your R equivalent. Now, if you go back to your problem, you can see here, they have given that the current is 250 milliamps, the main voltage is 5 volts. So now I will use the Ohm's law. So if I use Ohm's law, that is V is equal to I into R. Now what is V? V is nothing but 5 volts they have already given. I is 250 milliamps. So 250 milli needs to be written. You can't miss this. Milli into what is R? R is nothing but R equivalent now, right? So 2400 R plus 48,000 divided by 110 R plus. So you have to find out what is R from this equation. So first let me multiply this 250 into 10 to the power minus 3 with this and find out what is my equation in this side. So 5 is equal to, you had 250 milliamps. So multiply this, so you will get 250 into 10 to the power minus 3 into 2400. So that will be 600. So 600 R plus again 250 into 10 to the power minus 3 into 48,000. So that will give you 12,000 divided by 110 R plus 2800. So now you can cross multiply. So 5 into 110 R plus 2800. So from this equation now you can find out what is R. Yes, R will be equal to 40 ohms. So this is your answer.